Hi, welcome to our video on setting up a Zoom meeting in Blackboard. There are two ways to go about doing this, and this video will demonstrate both. The first way is to create the meeting in Blackboard itself. The second way is to create the meeting in Zoom first. The first and easiest way to set up the meeting is in Blackboard. All you have to do is navigate to the place where you would like to set the meeting up. In my case, I have a section called Zoom Meetings, and I'll click there. From there, let's go to Build Content, and you can see there is an option for Zoom Meeting. Now, all I have to do is give it a name. I can add a description if I would like. I can attach files. If I want this to be a graded discussion, for example, I can enable grading. All of that is really up to you. Once I'm done, I can simply click Submit. Now, you can see my Zoom meeting has appeared here, Class Discussion 2. And when I click on that as the instructor, that will automatically launch a Zoom meeting. So all I have to do is click on the blue box to join the meeting. As you can see, this is a really quick and easy way to set up a meeting in Zoom. Just a quick word of caution, however, that you cannot change the settings for the Zoom meeting within Blackboard itself. If you want to change any of the settings, you do have to go to VCU's Zoom site, which is vcu.zoom.us. And I'll show you very quickly how to go ahead and change the settings in a Zoom meeting you've already set up on Blackboard. So first, let's sign in. Now that I've logged in, I'm going to click on Meetings. And I can see a list of all of the meetings that I have scheduled with my Zoom account. So you'll notice here that I do have three meetings with the same exact name, and this is the name of my course in Blackboard. Unfortunately, when you create meetings in Blackboard, this is how they all appear. So if you're planning on creating a bunch of different meetings for different purposes, you might want to create the meetings in a different way to avoid confusion. Each meeting does have a meeting ID over here on the right, and you can find that in your Zoom meeting, but only once you open up the Zoom meeting itself. So it's not necessarily an easy and user-friendly way to track which meeting is which. So if you're concerned about being able to easily sort through many different meetings you're planning on creating, stay tuned for the second half of this video, in which we'll take a look at a different way to create Zoom meetings in Blackboard. So if I would like to edit the meeting that I just created in Blackboard, I'll just find whichever meeting it is, click on that. Here's the meeting. I'm going to go down to the bottom, edit this meeting. So this is where you can edit the details of the meeting, and you can take a look at this and change whatever you would like. There's only one thing that I want to point out to you, and that is the default option for Zoom meetings created in Blackboard are for students to be able to join before the host. Yes. So that means that students would be able to enter into the Zoom meeting without you having started the session first. So that's just something to think about, whether or not you would like that to be enabled on your Zoom meetings. If it's something you're not interested in, then again, you do have to go into Zoom to actually be able to change that. So again, taking a look at the options for the Zoom meeting you created in Blackboard is not something that you have to do. If you just want to throw a meeting up on Blackboard and not tamper with the settings, you can certainly do that, but just know that you can change the settings if you find it necessary. When I'm done, I'll just click Save, and then my meeting is good to go. The second way that I can create a Zoom meeting to share with my students is to create the meeting in Zoom first and then post it to Blackboard. So to do that, I will simply go to Zoom, click Meetings, and then click Schedule a New Meeting. So here's where you'll set up all the options for your Zoom meeting. You'll start with a topic, and that's basically the title for your Zoom meeting. You can add a description if you want. You can set up a particular date and time for the meeting to take place, as well as a duration. If this is a meeting that you would like to recur multiple times, you can adjust the settings here and have it occur daily or weekly or monthly. It's up to you how you would like to adjust that. And in addition, there's some important settings if we go on down to meeting options. You can enable students to join before the host, like we talked about before. You can have participants muted when they come into the room, which may be particularly helpful if you have a very large group and you don't want everyone talking at once or hearing all the background noise at once. And then the last thing I will point out is you can also Enable recording automatically. This of course means that as soon as you start your Zoom session, it will begin recording. That's something that can be particularly useful if, for example, you're recording a lecture and you want it to be available to students later who were unable to attend. Once I have my settings like I want them, I'll simply click Save. From here, it's really a matter of just copying and pasting the information about the Zoom meeting over into Blackboard. So the easiest thing to do is to click on Copy the Invitation. This is all the information about the Zoom meeting your students might need. Copy invitation. Now it's copied to my clipboard. And I'm going to go back over to Blackboard now. So all I need to do is click over where I would like to add my meeting. And then I'm going to go to Build Content. This time, let's select Item. And here I'm going to enter a title for the class. And in this text box is where I'm going to enter in the invitation from Zoom that I copied over. So I'm simply going to do a Control V to copy that. This is a bunch of information about the meeting that students might need. Mostly they just need the link, but if they're going to need to dial in by phone or anything like that, that information is here. So you may just want to copy the whole invitation. To make your life easier, you might want to go ahead and make this link for the meeting a hyperlink. So just highlight it. Click on this hyperlink button right here. And then let's just go ahead and copy in the link for the meeting into both of these two boxes. Click Insert. So now as you can see, because it's blue and it's underlined, that's a hyperlink that my students can click on. All right, I can adjust any of the other settings that I want to. When I'm done, click Submit. Okay, now you can see that my Zoom meeting and all of the necessary information in the invitation has appeared in Blackboard. And to start the meeting, my students could simply click on the link. And of course, from here, the meeting will launch and your Zoom meeting is ready to go. So that's all you need to know about setting up a Zoom meeting in Blackboard. Again, you have two different methods. They both work equally well. It's just a matter of personal preference. I hope you found this video helpful.